Hey everyone, the Game Piece here, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be going over where to capture the brand new Temtem introduced today in the brand new update with the Kilima Peaks and the Barifu Glacier. So let's get right into where you can capture these brand new Temtem, including YOWLAR and MOMO. So MOMO is actually going to be one of the first Temtem you encounter once you reach the cable car and rise up into the Kilima Peaks. You'll be able to run into the grass right there, and there you'll find MOMO. MOMO is a very, very cute wolf slash dog Temtem. Its traits are very interesting as well, so let's take a look at its stats right now. So taking a look at MOMO's stats here, you'll be able to see that it's pretty well-rounded except for its suffering in its attack and defense departments. However, its special attack and special defense and speed all make up for it in my opinion. Those are very strong stats base-wise and pretty decent HP as well as 75. Stamina is a little bit lackluster, but you can build a little bit extra to make up for that. Now let's move on to its traits. So starting off with Stabmaster here, you'll be able to increase damage done with matching type techniques by 50%. So if you have a neutral type technique, you're going to be able to increase the stab by 50%. So instead of the already natural stab bonus that it gets being 50%, you'll increase that to basically 100%. And then moving on to Snowstorm, whenever MOMO enters the battlefield for the very first time, so this can only activate one time in a battle, rivals and the ally on your side of the field will get the cold status for 2 turns. So it's important to keep in mind if you are using this that your Temtem that you pair up with MOMO and send out is also going to be getting that cold status. And you might be wondering why would I want to do that? Well, there is an ability that YOWLAR has actually that will take advantage of this. One more thing I wanted to point out for MOMO though is that its TV yield is actually 3 speed TVs, so if you wanted to go ahead and farm speed TVs there, it seems like that might be a better location. They seem to spawn pretty frequently up at the Kilima Peaks. But now let's take a look at YOWLAR. YOWLAR will actually be found in the Barifu Glacier, which is just a short ways ahead of the Kilima Peaks in that first area that you arrive at. Taking a look at YOWLAR's base stats though, this thing is an absolute monster. Attack being 80, 86 defense, 74 special defense, 96 HP, and 71 stamina. This thing is a tank. The only problem is it's a little bit slow, but it does not matter. Its comebacker ability here, when attacked by a rival, damage done to the attacker is increased by 50% during the same turn. So if you receive damage before your attack goes out, your damage is going to be increased by 50%, which is pretty huge. So you pretty much want to be slower in the first place with YOWLAR here. But let's move on to its next trait, it's cold-blooded. Instead of getting cold status, the Temtem will receive regenerate status for 2 turns. So if you wanted to use MOMO along with YOWLAR, you could set up some regenerating stacks on top of YOWLAR if you wanted to do it that way. It could take some strategy planning around the freezing and regenerating if you wanted to recoup some damage. But yeah, definitely looks like a very strong Temtem. Also giving 3 HP TVs, same as Psypet, so it doesn't look like the TV training course is going to change there too much. But yeah, both these Temtem are looking insanely strong. I'm very excited to see what they are capable of and how it shakes up the meta. Speaking of the meta, there was a lot of balance updates and adjustments today in the patch notes. We'll be going over that in a separate video and be going over some of the changes that are pretty notable. So lots of changes coming to Temtem today with this update. We're also going to have some more videos going over housing and all of that fun stuff. So if you guys are interested in learning more about Temtem and learning more about the update that just happened, please feel free to hit subscribe. And if you like the video, please feel free to leave a like if you enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the update and enjoying the new Temtem. MOMO is fantastic. I can see why it is y'all's favorite Temtem. It is absolutely wonderful, but really nice to get our hands on both these guys finally. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below about these new Temtem, and thank you guys once again for watching, and I hope you guys enjoy the update and have a great rest of your day.